Modesto runner who survived in snowy mountains for 2 days is now talking about his ordeal for the first time. Bob Root is back home and safe, and KCRA3's Melinda Meza had a chance to talk to him a short time ago. She's live for us in Modesto with how Root says he kept himself alive. An amazing story, Melinda.
It sure is an amazing story with a great ending. But we talked to some people here at Root's Running Club. They say he was in great physical shape. But when I talked to Bob Root today, he says his mindset of not allowing himself to think that he couldn't make it out alive kept him alive.
Yay!
55-year-old Bob Root returned home to Modesto today after being lost in freezing conditions for 2 days.
I'm tired, but I feel good. I'm very happy to be here.
Root and his running group went out Sunday morning on the Western States Trail in Placer County when Root thought he could run ahead and catch up with a second group. But that didn't happen. He got lost.
I got to this clearing out there and I couldn't see the trail. I didn't know which trail to go on, so I lost the trail. And so what happened is I ended up meandering my way down to the horseshoe bend in the American River.
Root says he thought he could follow the river to find his way back.
It was very steep, so I just slid on my rear end down to a point where I couldn't go any further because it dropped off in some cliffs.
Root stayed there that night. He said the first night wasn't too bad, but the next night he had to deal with snow and freezing temperatures.
I didn't really let myself get too freaked out about anything or too scared about it. Because if I did that, I knew I'd have to fight that battle in order to get out. I was sitting there and I'd fall asleep. I had these micro sleeps. And I couldn't help it. My body just kept going, and then I'd tip over and I'd wake up, and I'd tip over and I'd fall forward and I'd wake up.
Root tells us he would start shivering. Then he said he would tighten his core and his body would stop for a minute. He said he only had one protein bar and glucose tablets to eat.
I would not allow myself to think that. Yeah. If that thought, I pushed that away. It wasn't going to happen.
Root says he told himself he would crawl out if he had to, and he says he's grateful for all the people who prayed, all who searched.
I'm just thankful. I thank them from the bottom of my heart very much.
And people are definitely celebrating his safe return tonight in Modesto. Root's Running Club is back at Appetit's restaurant celebrating, and all proceeds are going to Root's favorite charity. $500 has already been raised. A good time down here in Modesto. I'm Melinda Meza reporting live, KCRA 3 News.
Yeah, plenty of reason to celebrate. Okay, I think I know the answer to this, but is he planning on doing any more running in the near future?
Oh, yeah, we asked him that very question. Now, he was going to run a 50-mile run this weekend. He did cancel that, but he has a marathon scheduled for next month, and he says he'll keep on running.
Oh, just a marathon. Okay, well.
Yeah, just a marathon.
All right, well, best of luck to him, and it's just the best outcome you could hope for given the situation. Yeah. Thanks, Melinda. Well, while Root's story is amazing, survival experts say he didn't follow the number one rule of search and rescue, which is to stay put if you find yourself disoriented in the wilderness. Experts say you should get out of the wind and the elements and create a sign that helps point to your location.